Alright, I try to make a quicker video because I've been, I don't know, making too long of ones. But this was about, okay, I'm going to talk about opera and why am I getting such a commitment against it? You know, why am I getting a commitment, a voice localized here by a few that they don't like opera? And I'm like, well, is it the way I'm singing? I could take it personally. But then I'm like, you know, I don't believe so. I believe they really don't like opera. So is it certain songs? You know, is there a certain jurisdiction of songs that are allowed that they prefer? Now, you know, I'm thinking, well, I can understand maybe, you know, these yippee-yippee-hypee ones. Bel Masetto or whatever. Maybe they wear on them because they're so positive. Is that what it is? They're so positive. They have a positive happiness. Now, one would think that would be normal and healthy to hear. Normal and healthy. But if you're attacked because you are singing these happy-go-lucky songs, and there are songs of a happy state, in a happy state, that would mean that the others are choosing happiness as a narrow hill that they're not ever going to climb. They prefer despondency. So you are dealing with people who are discontent, who are pessimists, severe pessimists. Optimism gone long ago. No happy state allowed. So I guess that is the killant of opera, is when we have the happy yappy voices and the pessimist is so heavy and thick in preference to death, disruption, evils, and hatreds, vileness, scandal. And disquiet. I can think of, well, I can go back to nature itself. You know, what is the, do we have a parallel with nature, like an animal creature? You know, you have the happy butterfly, you know, happy butterfly, even Madame Butterfly, the name itself. You know, you have the happy butterfly, and then yet, in the despondent states that I dislike opera, I hate opera, I hate happiness, you know, those people. Is that the reason? Are they the ones who would it be? You know, like in the nature state, who is the nature animal? Who is the nature animal that would be that dedicated against? Well, we could say, who eats birds? Who eats the little songbirds? Well, I have to think of it. Who eats the little songbirds? No, I'm not kidding. Like, really. Aside from the French in the south of there, who eats those little tiny songbirds? I imagine that lizards, there are lizards who catch them, There are giant spiders in like the Amazon, who wrap and coil them up and make these giant huge webs, and the birds fly in and then they get stuck with their wings out there like this. Yes, little tiny birds get stuck there in the spider's web. So it could be spiders, it could be lizards. Now who else? Who else absolutely in the nature kingdom? I don't even think it's like coyotes. No, I don't think it's coyotes. I don't think it's the wolves. The wolves, if anything, would maybe eat the eggs. No, I don't believe it's anything that's four-legged like a dog. What creature? What creature is after the happy little birds? The monkeys aren't out there grabbing at their tails, are they? There may be a few monkeys. There might be a few monkeys just to do jest with them, but I don't believe in the animal kingdom they're actually there to eat them. So who is after the birds in the animal kingdom? Well, aside from the human beings. Now who? My gosh, I can't even find an animal. No. It's ridiculous. They're that loved and wanted. They're that appreciated. They're that needed, that necessary. Why would we stop them? Other birds. Yeah, other birds perhaps. Yes, we can say the other birds. Okay, so we have the other birds. We have the hawks, the hawk family. We have the predator birds. That's it. The birds after the birds. But not another animal. I know, it's just something to think about, isn't it? Something to think about. No. There are no major predators. They're not the tigers, not the lions, not the what do we call them? The cutesy wootsies, the bears. Nothing like this. Not even the wolverines are after. No. Oh, there's the cats. The lynxes. Okay, all right. The lynxes. I'll give that. We have the predator lynx. Now, they're tinier cats. Those tiny cats are the ones that are after. The tiny lynx. The tiny, what do we call them? I'm not even going to say cougars. I'm not going to say the panthers. They're not after birds. It's only those little tiny lynxes. So those cats. All right. So that is the predator group that is non-bird. We have the giant lizard, the green giant green lizard, and we have the predator lynx, and those are the only ones there. So it's odd, yeah. So it's odd. So I guess if you're having problems with a neighbor who doesn't like the opera, well, I imagine you can look at them that way, that they're either the giant green lizard, or they are a tiny lynx. That's it. If they are the hawk predator style, they think they are a bird themselves, I would find that difficult to believe. They would have to be a singer also. So yeah, I'm looking at the lizard or the lynx. I know, that's a strange video.